Staying tuned to Boss Lady News. I'm your host, Britt Johnson, and our next guest is LaToya Smith. Hey! How are you?
I'm great, thank you.
Have a seat. So, this isn't your first time on.
No.
And I'm so thankful that you had time to come on today.
Thank you.
You've got your little ones here with us,
yes,
and
yes.
It's always amazing to have the young people in the audience. And, you know, you're a day trader.
Yes.
And for anyone that didn't get a chance to see our previous interview, so I'll just give the viewers a little bit, you know. Tell us a little bit about yourself. Are you originally from the Boston area?
So I'm originally from Boston, yes. Grew up in Dorchester and went to school in Massachusetts. So I went to Madison Park for high school.
Nice.
Went to Framingham State for college and went to nine to five work life. And then that's when I formed the investment club with some friends, and I got into the stock market per se that way.
Right.
And I just began watching the price movements in our portfolio, and then I realized something just hit me like, hold on, I can make money short term. And that's how it all started from there.
So your 9 to 5, was that dealing with the stock market?
So my 9 to 5 was in investment banking. So
okay.
I needed a finance degree or accounting degree or something in order to be in the field that I went to work in. So I worked for a custodial bank, I worked for a State Street Bank, and then eventually I ended up working for an investment bank, which was Deutsche Bank.
Okay.
So throughout that, I was still very active and wanting to participate in the markets, and that's when I bought a house, all of that, yada, yada.
Absolutely.
And then afterwards, I'm like, it just hit me. Am I going to stay working so I could pay for a house that I'm barely in? Or do I need to find something where I can get back my time? And that's when I'm like, you know what? I'm going to do this for real, because I really enjoy the markets. I was making money in the markets while working. So I'm like, I know for a fact.
So you were making money,
yep.
But you were making more money for your clients.
Well, I did a lot of back end work in investment banking. So I wasn't necessarily the driver, if that makes sense. With investment banking, there's all sorts of different things that go into a mutual fund aspect. For example, if you had a 401k, a retirement account, all of that has different components to make that work.
Okay.
So you need your analysts, they need to do research, you need compliance, they need to stay in compliance with the actual laws that govern mutual funds. You need your accountants to keep track of the books. You need, there's so many things. You need your lawyers, you need the people that put together the prospectus. Is a lot of stuff. So I did the expense side of things. So I kept track of bills being paid out or management fees, because the managers that's managing the money has to get paid. So
there's
a whole industry that pays a lot of people, and that industry actually has a lot of jobs that connects to it. So it's not that we were making our clients money, it's just the way the field was.
Yeah, so some of the logistics work that's done behind it. So you mentioned that you created then an investment club.
The investment club part of things, it was about 6 to 7 of us. I think starting out it was 5, and then eventually we got members to come on board. We did everything from scratch, meaning grassroots. We had to form the bylaws that govern the investment club. We met once a month. We pooled our money. We had different roles. I was the treasurer, so I was responsible for taking that money that was pooled, putting it into our account, and then eventually transferring it into our brokerage account.
Okay.
And as a group, we'll vote. We'll bring our research on the stocks we wanted to buy for the month, and then I'll go in based on the decisions that was made and buy the stock based on everyone. And we'll track the portfolio throughout the course of time. Outside of day trading, I did start a company which is called The Profit Room. And the whole focus and goal of my company, along with my partner, he's based in New Jersey, his name is Ernest, the whole focus is for us to educate as many people in terms of how to invest or trade in the markets, either to replace your income or make short-term income basically so you can get back your time?
So I do a little bit of both. So because I'm self-employed, I have to have my own Roth IRA. I have to take care of my future for the sake of my kids and et cetera. But also for, I call it now money, that short-term income. That's when I go into the markets. I sit down maybe 1 or 2 hours, and I benefit from the price fluctuation.
Okay.
Because, you know, every day, either the market's doing great or bad, you see it on the news. Mm-hmm. Hey, the Dow, the SPY, we're dropped a percent or whatever. So when you think of stuff like that, just know that the markets are moving all the time.
Okay.
And there are price fluctuations in a stock like Apple, Google, because you'll see the change if you look at your portfolio long term. But just imagine on a daily basis, you can catch that change within the stocks.
Wow.
So let me give you an example, like Bank of America. Bank of America is about $29.50. I don't know if it's that now, but if it drops 50 cents in a day, that's a lot of money for a day trader. All we need is 50 cents to a dollar, sometimes less, to make money. Other aspects of the market, too, where there's other participants worldwide.
Mm-hmm.
So you get into the futures market, which is commodities, your oil, your sugar, your wheat, your soybean. So when like they discuss stuff with China in the news, that's very relative to the market.
Mm-hmm.
That's very relative to the farmers. I don't know if you know about the farmers hurting that industry because China is a large producer, or not a producer, but a consumer of our soybeans.
Okay.
But since the tariffs happened, they no longer take.
And the tariffs are when the president kind of
enforces
made
those taxes at a higher rate on Chinese, and they're not having it. So with the markets, everything pieced together.
Okay.
You'll understand politics more. You'll understand how the economy moves and how the economy works.
Mm-hmm.
Believe it or not, you're gonna understand real estate so much better too.
Okay.
Everything ties in together when you're dealing with the financial markets.
Well,
it's
right
one
now,
big system.
Right now, my head is like poof.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to cut to a break so that I can bring it back together. But don't go anywhere. We are on set with LaToya Smith. We're talking about day trading and understanding the market. And so we'll take a quick break. You guys grab some water, run to the bathroom, come right back, okay? You're watching Boss Lady News. Thank you guys for staying tuned to Boss Lady News. We're on set with LaToya Smith. We are talking about the market, and we're talking about day trading.
Never think about day trading as a main priority. Get started learning what investing is first.
Okay.
I always say a lot of people have smartphones. On your smartphone, download an app, CNBC app. That will keep you up to date with market news.
Okay.
Another thing is, as consumers per se, we like to purchase certain things. So if you have a favorite shoe or sneaker, Nike, how about take that actual store you purchased from, Nike, and look at the stock, track it for over a course of time, become familiar with the actual stock.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that's a good way to get started. If it piques your interest to look at something which you actually consume.
How do you trust what it is that you're seeing daily to be something you want to consistently be watching?
Just look at everyone around you. You will always find, like, if someone has, for example, let's use an Apple product, the phones, how long have they been in existence? How long have Walmart been in existence? How long have Target or Macy's? So you're really looking at those companies that's been around probably longer than you have, forever. So that would be your first start in actually investing.
Mm-hmm.
And those companies are called blue chips. That's your blue chip stocks because they've been around for a very long time.
Okay. Now, we've only got 1 minute left, but you've got the profit room on.
Yes.
And we're talking about profit. Now, I want to drive people to the profit room. When they go to theprofitroom.com, what are they seeing? What are they doing? What are they learning?
Generally, when you hit our site, usually we do provide webinars. So the webinars are free just to get people introduced into the market, where to start, what books we recommend, etc. But other than that, we do gear people into, like, we have services that we provide. We have day trading services, we have short-term trading services, mm-hmm. and also we offer courses in a form of mentorship for anyone that needs that hand-on-hand training
right.
in order to get started.
Well, please hold my hand.
Yes.
Because I need that hand-on-hand training. Well, we're going to have you on again.
All right.
And we might try to do an out of studio, see if we can get on the computer, start seeing numbers, and you kind of explain them
definitely.
To us. But anyone can reach out to you and visit The Profit Room. And if they want to email you, can
yes.
they email you
they
as well?
They can email me as well. I can be found at latoya@theprofitroom.com. That's my email. I do respond.
And thank you so much for coming on.